Okay, and really, now I am planning to show you the way to repair this my boot hole so that this my repair lasts at least 3 to 5 years. And this is my long lasting repair. And let's go to look at what things I need that I can repair, like this 1-inch cut in my boot, and how this is possible to do water sealant and waterproof this area. And first step is actually that you must have high quality boots. Like in that my case, there is high quality rubber, what normally lasts 5 to 10 years. And this is not made in China. This is high quality boots. And this my boot cost about $100 to $200 per piece, this one set. And if you have very cheap made in China boot, then I don't recommend these repairs, because low quality boots, they are made so scrap materials that it is not wise to repair. But if you have high quality boots, then I recommend. And this material can be rubber or leather or some synthetic material. Okay, and then what kind of things I need for that repair? Okay, let's go to forward all of these things. And first one is that I must have high quality glue. And this is the thing and stuff what we need. We need to purchase in Sika elastic glue, and like in this 2-to-1 is the best one, and there are different colors. And now we need to firstly find, like, black is the best one because my boot is black, but now I don't have in my garage this black one, and that's I recommend that I use white or brown. And I have two these tubes, and this is the best one, this number 2-to-1, and you can purchase this like eBay or Amazon.com. And also in USA there is number, if I remember right, 2-to-9 or 2-to-8. And this glue must be this elastic and sealant. It is like it makes this glue what is very hard but also elastic. This is the trick. And firstly, and the brand is only this Sika. And this come from Europe, small country, what name is Switzerland. I have visited in there, and this Sika is best brand. And I have used now this product about 40 or 30 years. 30 years use. This is like in glues Toyota. This is similar quality than like Toyota in cars, but this is glue maker from Switzerland. Okay, and this is first step. Purchase that one. All other glues are scrap, remember. All scraps. They are not usable for that kind of difficult things. And this is first one we need Sika, because we install soon this glue in that hole, and it must be elastic, like this rubber or leather, and also extremely durable. And Sika is the solution. Okay. And after that, we need some, because I am engineer. I am professional engineer. We need some support material, like Kevlar in our US Army helmet. We need some support material what resist hits and all kind of movements. And I have to install in this outer area this Kevlar plate cover. And we need, so next thing, we need some material what is durable and elastic. And Kevlar is one of those, but this my one, this is not Kevlar. This is like this material, cloth. This is synthetic material, what we use in home building. We install this kind of material in when we are doing holes in home construction building, and we need to install in down like some material like sand or this mud, and then in that upper area rock. This is like material what insulates two different material layers. And also, if you think that should I use like this rubber gloves, this can be okay, but this is not so durable. Look, when I scratch that, soon this part opens. And this is not good support material, because this is extremely durable. This is not the bulletproof, but extremely. When I try to bend, you have to test that when you press in another direction, it must be last, like in that one. This is good. Then someone can think that how about my paper, Amazon carton box. This is 2 weeks. And then how about my old blanket, cotton. This is actually durable, but this is 2 weeks if I can scratch. But this is so hard that it is difficult to scratch this my cover. And then one of the best is that if you have old Honda Civic or Toyota Corolla, and this is driver's side seat cover, this is extremely well material for this rubber boots repair, because seats material is excellent, especially in these two Japanese car makers, Honda and Toyota. And I have in here one Honda seat, and there's even material that TS Tech, they have made these things, and it seems that AG, it is maybe in German or Switzerland. Okay, and this is really cool if this is made in Switzerland, same country like in my Sika glue. And this is really from Honda Civic car, this cover. It's excellent. And then I have one old car, some kind of bag, and there is also similar hard material what is suitable that for that cover this support material. But now I use this black material because they are same color in here. And this is like second thing, and third thing is that when I handle this Sika glue, there is even some marking. Sika glue is so this fantastic glue that it takes so hard grip in our skin, and that's we have to use protective rubber this gloves, because otherwise we have bad spots in our skin, and this Sika glue is harmful to our body and this skin. This glue generates cancer, like all these synthetic glues. But next one is that purchase good quality this protective gloves, because soon there is a lot of this Sika glue in my hands. This is like 13. Otherwise you have glove what is full of like black glue, and it is difficult and hurtful. Okay, and then we are in fourth thing is that we have to visit in Home Depot store in USA or in another country, and we have to purchase good quality sandpaper. And in like my one, when we look in this back area, if you can find in here text that made in Japan or especially made in USA or made in Germany or England, then you have high quality paper. And even that if there is made in Switzerland, this is also good quality. Interesting that I have 13 what is made in Switzerland. But Swiss really do, they are like German quality makers. And now we have this fourth thing, we need sandpaper, because I have to scratch this area, that there are those lines and good contact. And then this final thing is that we need some compression tool. We can purchase that one also in ebay.com. And this is this glue compression tool when I compress this Sika glue away. I install that in here and then in that one, and then I press and soon glue comes out in here. Okay, and in this my current compressor tool is especially good. It is made by Cox, and I have purchased this from Amazon.com or eBay.com, and can you believe, there is text, made in England, best country, same quality like there is made in USA. Excellent. And maker is Cox, and you can purchase this from Amazon.com or so on. And this is totally steel, and when it is made in England, this lasts normally at least 10 years. This is durable, not in made in China stuff. Okay, and final fourth thing is my electric tool. Okay, and final fifth thing is what we need, is that we need heater. We have to heat up this our area, because there is water and humidity, and you can also use your hair dryer, what women and men use. This an idea is that we need hot air, what heat ups and dries this area. And this is actually my first step, and we start this repair with this heating this area, and now we remove the water and humidity. Water humidity. Okay, and now I need to really turn off this my heater, and I have to heat that so long that all water and wet comes out in this inner area also. Now it's going to turn on, and I heat that. I heat up that about 1 minute, and then I need to open this area also, because in there inside is water and all kind of sands what I have to remove. And let's go to look closer. Okay, and now we look closer in this area, in there. And we can use some tools, like screwdriver, that I can open this area better, because I need to take this, I need to remove this water in that way. And we can feel when we install our finger, remember, this is hot, do not burn your fingers. And when we install in inside, and now it's hot, and that's I need pliers in that way. And when these all areas became white, then this area is dry. Okay, and now if we can see some smoke, then this is at least dry. And do not overheat, because this is like rubber and these parts can cause damage. But now I believe that this is dry. And next step is that I take this my sandpaper, What number is 40? This 40 or 60 is good. We go home, when we go to Home Depot, we ask that salesperson, please give to us sandpaper. What this hardness, this rough is 60 or 40. And then I install my hand in there inside. This is actually important that I install my hand in here. And soon I have to install also protective glove. Actually now I do that. Because soon this inner area is full of glue. And that's I need to use this my protective hand. In that way that I install this protective hand in here. And now it is important that I, there's my finger, that I press these areas in here and same time there is sandpaper. But I sand this area where I am planning to use this glue in that way that there must be this cracks. Cracks purpose is that glue makes and takes better contact. Okay, excellent. Now this looks very nice. Excellent. I'm very happy. And remember to keep these protective hands in both of your hands. Now I install the second one also. Okay, and now this protect. Okay, and then next step is that when I have this my support plate, I have to do a nice circle in here. And for that purpose, I need now my cutting scissors. Okay, and we really need amount for this only of that. And now this my material is too big. And that's I cut this area in like nicely. Nicely modern nice circle. And you can do oven type. Now it looks good. Excellent. And then this area becomes in here. Excellent. Looks great. And now I use this my glue. And really, if you can purchase Sika 221, this cost about $20 per piece, this tube. And we can use that in longer time when we tap that hole. Okay, and the Sika use, this how we use that, we need some sharp head point, spike, that we can cut this small layer in here. There is like closing area, it is a small aluminium, like beer cans, and when I press that carefully in, look, it opens that. And now it goes, be carefully. And now we have in here white material. Okay, this white is not the best one in this my current black boots, but if you have only white glue, then we can paint this area. And I will in final step use my black this spray paint and I will paint this my white glue soon, but this is only, that's it is good that if we use same color, black glue and black boot. Now I have white glue and black. It is not the best one, but I can later really spray paint this area. Okay, and now I take this my glue compression tool. I install this my glue pullet in here and then I compress that little by little and glue comes in here nicely, look. And now it is important, take your left hand and install that inside in here. This is critical. And your hand must be in here in that way, fingers. Because firstly, the install in this whole cut area, this glue. And now this glue must be go in also inner area. In that way, look. I install it there. Now we can see that glue goes in there. It is important that, and I compress same time in this press. Okay, and it is better to almost use more glue than low amount. And now I open this cut and I press. Now I have a little, I need better close because soon I have this glue in my thumb. Okay, now it goes in there and then this my inner hand, it press this glue so that there is no any big dent in inner area. And then I install this glue in all that areas where I am planning to install this protective support plate in that way. Look, looks good. And then I keep my fingers in the in here inner area. They check and they move that inner area is similar. And then I take this my support area. This is critical. This makes this repair to last in that way. In this way, look how nice cover. And now it is important that this glue is all areas in down and up area. And that's I have to add is my glue in a little bit in here. That way. And in here. Okay, and then I use my finger that I can add this nicely. Now it is important that this my cover plate goes nicely. And now we can do in here this waterproof sealant. Excellent. And this glue must be cover all areas in that my hole. And now it is actually good if we press a little bit deeper. Now I add more glue. There glue comes out in the central area. Excellent. And now I add in here glue. In that way, looks good. And this glue is the core and main point. Because this is so fantastic made in Switzerland. And remember that this glue is elastic and also harmful. Install this glue to wait about 4 hours in outside, or actually one day that it becomes totally dry, and then you can use this thing. And then this is really glue what is difficult to take out in fingers. And okay, now I install this glue in my hand, look. And if that kind of situation happens, now I take also this another hand. I have to use gasoline or thinner and immediately remove this white stuff. Because this, when this dries, this is almost impossible to remove. And we remove that using sandpaper or knife. This is only my mistake. Sometimes I can use some cotton cloth in that way that I remove this stuff. Now I managed to remove. Look, this is clean already. Nice. Okay, and now this my repair is really almost ready. And final step is that I have to wait about 4 hours. And then I can install this final paint in there. And look, this is not the status. Clean these stuffs away when this is wet. Because when this is dry, it is almost impossible to take out in our nails and skin. Okay, and then final part is that I can tap this my glue. And I will show that how to do that. But soon I will paint this thing, and then you can see that what is result. And remember to check also in this inner area with your protective hand that there is no any dents. And I will, because this, if we install in inside really big glue dent, then it is difficult to use this boot. Okay, and now I have new protective glove in my hand, and now I like to check this inner area that there is no any extra glue in that area, because our foot, now I check that it is nice, okay, no any issues. Okay, good. Okay, and I moved my finger in that way, and now we can see that there is this glue and everything looks good. And then we let this thing to dry like 4 hours to like one night, like 12 hours. And in tomorrow this area is elastic and ready for painting. Okay, good. And then I tap this my glue, and you can see that thing also. Okay, and now final step is to paint this my boot in same color like this original old one. And old one is black, and there is my this spray paint. I have black this spray paint, and now I paint this area. Now this my boot, it has been repaired, and as you can see how nice shiny thing there is. And now this my job is ready, and in same way you have now really excellent sealant, and you can do that repair again and again, and maybe these boots can last like 20 or 40 years, like example Toyota cars last. And this is like this new recycle environment process, that we repair high quality items. And these boots were high quality things. And that kind of information to you, my friend.